Hello, namaskara, dear students. Today let us learn on Introduction to Constitution of India, Formation and Composition of the Constituent Assembly, Drafting Committee and its Contributions. Yes, before starting with the Indian Constitution, let us look at the history of India. As we all know, in ancient India, India was ruled by kings and queens, some queens. There was no scope for any regulatory mechanism. The king was having the full authority to make the rules and laws as per his wish and will. There was no guidelines. Whatever he does was through the will of a god, and everyone was following the guidelines issued from the king, because everyone treat the king as a god during that period. Then, as we all know that the British came to India, they ruled us almost more than 200 years. During this period, people of India suffered a lot, faced many difficulties, and many of them struggled a lot for independent India. We can see that many freedom fighters of India here. Out of them, the main freedom fighters are Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, Jawaharlal Nehru, Mahatma Gandhi, Nana Saheb, Lal Bahadur Shastri, Subhash Chandra Bose, and Sukhdev, many more. Dear students, let us know the history of Indian Constitution by watching a video here.
दोस्तों, सबसे पहला क्वेश्चन ये है कि भारत का संविधान क्यों बना? भारत कई वर्षों से गुलाम था और बाहर की शक्तियां भारत पर अपना शासन करती आ रही थी, और तो और देश पर अपने नियमों के अनुसार कार्य कर रही थी। सभी के अपने नियम थे। भारत आजादी के पहले 200 वर्षों तक अंग्रेजों का गुलाम रहा, इसलिए यहाँ ब्रिटिश नियम अनुसार कार्य होते रहे। इसलिए देश में आजादी जितनी जरूरी थी, उतनी ही जरूरी था देश का संविधान। भारत हमेशा से एक बहुत आबादी वाला देश रहा है, और इस आबादी को सही दिशा में आगे बढ़ाने के लिए देश के पास अपने नियमों, अधिकारों एवं कर्तव्यों की नियमावली होना बहुत जरूरी था, इसीलिए भारत का संविधान बना। दोस्तों, अब मैं आपको ये बता दूं कि किस तरह भारत संविधान की तरफ बढ़ा। सबसे पहले अंग्रेजी हुकूमत ने 1935 में भारतीयों के सामने एक नए एक्ट का ऐलान किया, जिसे भारतीय सरकार अधिनियम 1935 या गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया एक्ट भी कहा जाता है। इस कानून के कई नियम आज भी हमारे भारतीय संविधान में शामिल हैं, लेकिन यह कानून पूरी तरह से भारतीयों को कभी पसंद नहीं आया और भारत में काफ़ी द्वेष बढ़ गया। बाहर से दिखने पर यह अधिनियम संघीय शासन का था, लेकिन वास्तविक तौर पर सभी अधिकार गवर्नर के पास थे, जिसे जानकर लोग खुश नहीं थे। पंडित जवाहरलाल नेहरू ने तो इसे बिना इंजन की मशीन तक कहकर संबोधित किया, और इस तरह इसका विरोध पूरे देश में हुआ। सभी दलों और जानकारों के मतानुसार 1945 में डॉक्टर तेज बहादुर ने संविधान का एक प्रारूप तैयार किया, लेकिन अब तक भारत परतंत्र ही था। परंतु इस वक्त ब्रिटिश सरकार की द्वितीय विश्व युद्ध के कारण काफ़ी हालत खराब थी, और इनफैक्ट देश में भी एक के बाद एक नए आंदोलन, जैसे भारत छोड़ो आंदोलन, आज़ाद हिंद फौज का गठन होना, इन सबों ने ब्रिटिश हुकूमत को हिला कर रख दिया था। इनफैक्ट ब्रिटिश सरकार की अपने खुद के देश की स्थिति बहुत खराब थी, क्योंकि जो उनके वर्तमान प्रधानमंत्री चर्चिल थे, उनकी हार हो चुकी थी और नए प्रधानमंत्री बन चुके थे। ऐसे में सत्ता में आते ही भारत पर अपना कब्जा छोड़ना इन्हें थोड़ा रास नहीं आ रहा था। इन्होंने अपनी फूट नीति को अपनाया और कांग्रेस और मुस्लिम लीग को अलग कर देश के विभाजन की योजना बनाई। ब्रिटिश के वर्तमान प्रधानमंत्री ने कैबिनेट के 3 मंत्रियों को भारत भेजा और अपनी बात सबके सामने रखी। इस मिशन को कैबिनेट मिशन कहा गया। अब मैं आपको बताती हूँ कि कैबिनेट मिशन था क्या। यह मिशन 1946 में भारत आया, जिसमें 3 मुख्य सदस्य भारत भेजे गए। इस मिशन का मुख्य उद्देश्य उन विकल्पों को तलाशना था, जिसके जरिए भारत की सत्ता भारत के हाथों में सौंपी जा सके। उस समय कुछ ऐसी परिस्थिति उत्पन्न हुई कि कैबिनेट कमीशन की पहली बैठक पर कोई हल ना निकल सका। इस बैठक में मौलाना आज़ाद, सरदार वल्लभ भाई पटेल, पंडित जवाहरलाल नेहरू, खान अब्दुल गफ्फार खां, लियाकत अली खां, जिन्ना, नवाब इस्माइल खां और सरदार निश्तर तथा नवाब मोहम्मद हमीदुल्ला हाजिर थे। यह बैठक शिमला में हुई थी। अंग्रेजों ने अपनी जिद नहीं छोड़ी और 16 जून 1946 को देश के विभाजन का फैसला ले लिया और इस फैसले के साथ यह भी तय हुआ कि देश को आज़ादी मिल जाएगी और यहाँ से शुरुआत हुई संविधान बनने की प्रणाली का। अब मैं आपको बताती हूँ कि संविधान लिखने की शुरुआत कैसे की गई। जैसे ही ये स्पष्ट हुआ कि अंग्रेज भारत की सत्ता देश को सौंप देंगे, वैसे ही चिंता सबसे ज़्यादा ये थी कि भारत में अब अपना संविधान होना बहुत ज़रूरी है। संविधान की पहली बैठक डॉक्टर सच्चिदानंद की अगुवाई में हुई, जो कि 9 दिसंबर 1946 को हुई। इस सभा का अध्यक्ष पूर्व राष्ट्रपति डॉक्टर राजेंद्र प्रसाद को चुना गया। इसके बाद 13 दिसंबर 1946 को संविधान की एक रफ रूपरेखा तैयार की गई, जिसे पंडित जवाहरलाल नेहरू ने सबके सामने पढ़ा। इस संविधान में सबसे महत्वपूर्ण बात यह रखी गई कि अब देश में सभी राजाओं के शासन को समाप्त कर दिया जाएगा और भारत की प्रभुत्ता सबको स्वीकार करनी होगी। और 22 जनवरी 1947 को कई तरह के विरोध के बाद इस प्रस्ताव को पारित कर दिया गया। वैसे तो ये एक बहुत कठिन समझौता था, लेकिन सरदार वल्लभ भाई पटेल जैसे नेताओं ने सभी राजाओं को एकजुट किया और राजाओं ने कांग्रेस को अपना समर्थन दिया। 14 जुलाई 1947 को नेहरू जी ने संविधान की बैठक में देश के चिन्ह तिरंगा ध्वज का ऐलान किया और जिसका सभी ने तह दिल से समर्थन किया। इसके बाद अंग्रेजों के द्वारा हुई बातचीत के आधार पर भारत पाकिस्तान का विभाजन हो गया और इतने संघर्षों के बाद 15 अगस्त 1947 को देश आज़ाद हो गया। देश आज़ाद तो हो चुका था, लेकिन इसे एक दिशा में सुचारू रूप से गति देने के लिए भारत का संविधान अभी भी पूर्णतः नहीं बना था। पहले संविधान का ढांचा बनाया गया था, लेकिन बहुत सारे लोगों ने इसे स्वीकार नहीं किया गया था, इसलिए एक नई कमेटी का गठन किया गया। संविधान का निर्माण करने के लिए उसमें कुछ सदस्यों को जोड़ा गया, जिससे हर क्षेत्र को नेतृत्व की दृष्टि से प्रमुख लोगों को शामिल किया गया। संविधान को तैयार करने में 389 सदस्यों की भूमिका रही और इस समिति के सदस्य डॉक्टर भीमराव अंबेडकर को बनाया गया। संविधान की कमेटी में कौन कौन से सदस्य शामिल थे वो मैं आपको बता देती हूँ। उसमें थे डॉक्टर भीमराव अंबेडकर, संजय फेक, पंडित जवाहरलाल नेहरू, चक्रवर्ती राजगोपालाचार्य, डॉक्टर राजेंद्र प्रसाद, सरदार वल्लभ भाई पटेल, कन्हैयालाल मानकीलाल मुंशी, गणेश वासुदेव मावलकर, संदीप कुमार पटेल, अबुल कलाम आज़ाद, श्यामा प्रसाद मुखर्जी, नलिनी रंजना घोषाल, फ्रैंक एंथोनी, एचपी मोदी, हरेंद्र कुमार मुखर्जी, अरी बहादुर गुरुंग, अल्लदी कृष्णस्वामी अय्यर और महिला सदस्यों में सरोजिनी नायडू, हंसा मेहता, दुर्गाबाई देशमुख, अमृता कौर और विजय लक्ष्मी पंडित भी इस सभा में शामिल थे। सभी के विचार विमर्श, लड़ाई झगड़ों के साथ संविधान का प्रारूप तैयार होना शुरू हो गया, जिसकी घोषणा 9 दिसंबर 1947 को की गई। सभी सदस्यों के साथ मिलकर संविधान तैयार हुआ, जिसमें कई निर्णय हुए, जैसे मातृभाषा, राष्ट्रीय गीत, राष्ट्रीय गान, अधिकार, कर्तव्य आदि आदि। अब मैं आपको बता दूं कि संविधान कब बनकर तैयार हुआ और उसमें कितना समय लगा। सो दोस्तों, इतनी जनसंख्या वाले देश का संविधान, जहां कई तरह के धर्म, जाति, प्रजाति के लोग पाए जाते हैं, लिखना इतना आसान नहीं था। इसे लिखने में 2 वर्ष 11 माह और 18 दिन लग गए, जिसमें 114 दिनों तक आपसी बहस हुई और 12 अधिवेशन भी पेश किए गए। 166 दिन तक मीटिंग की गई और कई बार जनता से सलाह मशवरा भी किया गया, जिसके लिए प्रेस का सहारा लिया गया। और इस तरह 284 सदस्यों के हस्ताक्षर के बाद हमारे देश का संविधान 24 जनवरी 1950 को तैयार हो गया और इसे 26 जनवरी 1950 को पूरे देश में लागू किया गया, जिसे हम गणतंत्र दिवस के रूप में प्रतिवर्ष मनाते हैं। अब पॉइंट ये था कि संविधान 26 जनवरी को ही क्यों लागू किया गया। वैसे तो तारीखें और भी कोई हो सकती थी, लेकिन 26 जनवरी हमारे इतिहास की एक बहुत यादगार तारीख मानी जाती है, क्योंकि गणतंत्र दिवस के 20 वर्ष पहले, यानी 26 जनवरी 1950 से 20 वर्ष पहले 26 जनवरी 1923 को भारत में पूर्ण स्वराज का संकल्प लेकर कांग्रेस ने इसी दिन को स्वतंत्रता दिवस घोषित कर दिया था, जिसके बाद 15 अगस्त 1947 को भारत को स्वतंत्रता मिली और 26 जनवरी 1950 को भारत का संविधान घोषित किया गया। इस तरह 26 जनवरी का महत्व हमारे इतिहास में बहुत ज़्यादा अधिक है। आपको मैं भारत के संविधान का बहुत छोटा सा एक ब्रीफ देती हूँ कि भारत का संविधान 2016 तक 101 बार संशोधित किया जा चुका है। इस प्रकार इस संविधान में 448 अनुच्छेद, एक संविधान उद्देशिका, 12 अनुसूचित जातियाँ एवं 5 अनुलग्न शामिल हैं। इसमें अंतिम संशोधन जीएसटी को लेकर किया गया था। दोस्तों भारत का संविधान सबसे बड़ा लोकतंत्र का संविधान है, जिसकी विश्व में अपनी एक पहचान है। वैसे तो संविधान ब्रिटिश संविधान से प्रभावित है, लेकिन समय समय पर भारतवासियों के अनुसार इसमें संशोधन किए जाते रहे। सो दोस्तों, इस तरह उतार चढ़ाव के साथ भारत का संविधान बना। मुझे उम्मीद है मैं आपको इस बारे में सारी जानकारी देने में सफल रही।
What is constitution? You may ask this. Here, constitution is a document containing rules and regulations to govern a nation, whatever be the nation. To govern the nation, to control the nation, the rules and regulations made that document we call it as a constitution. And you may ask, from where we got this word constitution? The word constitution is obtained from Latin term constitute. Okay, what is introduction to Constitution of India? So this is asked in the examination as describe briefly about Indian constitution. Here it is given as the Constitution of India is the supreme law of India. It frames fundamental political principles, procedures, practices, rights, powers and duties of the government and mentions the fundamental rights and duties of citizens of India. That means what are the powers, duties, rights of the government and also what are the powers, duties, rights of the citizens of India is clearly defined in the Indian Constitution. The Constitution of India is the longest written communication of any country in the world, with 146,385 words in its English language version. And also we can have this version in Hindi language also. While the Constitution of Monaco is the shortest written communication, written constitution with 3,814 words. You can see that in all over world, ours is the longest written constitution. It declares also as India as a sovereign, socialist, democratic and republic with a parliamentary system of government. Sovereign means having supreme power, totally independent. Socialist means Samajavada, that is treating all the people equally and dividing the power, money to everyone equally. Democratic. Democratic means Praja Prabhutva, that is Prajagalinda, Prajagaligagi, Prajagaligoskara, Maduvanta Sarkara, that we call it as a democratic government. And Republic. Republic and the Praja Adhipatya, Ganarajya, Antnavakaritya, Praja Adhipatya, Prajagalidhali Adhipatyaro, Prajagalige Jasti Power Kottritare. So this is clearly defined in the Indian Constitution. Okay, you may ask why we need Constitution of India, why it is required. Okay, suppose if we are not having any constitution, what happens? There will be disorder, confusion, lawlessness in nation. So nobody will be knowing who is having the right, who is having the power, how to control the government, how to control the people of India. So it will be in a confusion. So to avoid this, to avoid the disorder, confusion, lawlessness in nation and also to ensure efficiency of government. Government hey kelsa maata ide antanthe heli check madlike. So for this the constitution is required. And also to control the powers of government by fundamental law. So government should not misuse its power. So to control on that, it has its own fundamental laws. Okay. To control the government for the sake of the individual. So individual should be protected. The citizen of India should be protected. For that, there should be certain rules made. So that will control the government and also the citizen of India. To limit the sudden desire of the present and future generation. So present generation, future generation, they will be having certain expectations, sudden desire they may be having. Sometimes it may be beyond the limit. So that should also have a control on it. So this is all declared, defined clearly in the Indian Constitution without any confusion, without any lawlessness. We can use this Indian Constitution for our sake and for the government's sake and also for the efficiency of the government working. Okay. What are the functions of a constitution? Here we can see many functions are given for a constitution. It provides the basic structure of the political system. So, what is the political system? Usually, the government, that is the central government, the state government, how it is made, what are the different powers of the government, central government and state government, what is the structure of that. So, everything is clearly defined in the Indian constitution. It reflects the aspirations of the people. Aspirations means strong desire. So, every people is having their strong desire about the Indian constitution, how it should be, what should be the rules made for the nation, for the people, for the government. So, that desire is reflected in the Indian constitution. It reflects the vision of the founding fathers. Founding fathers, for example, Mahatma Gandhiji, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, Jawaharlal Nehru. So many have fought for the freedom of our country and they were having the vision how the Indian constitution should be. So, this is reflected in this Indian constitution. It is the link between the people and the government. That means it establishes the connection between the people and also the government. It provides the guidance to govern the state. So, how the government should run? What are the guidelines for the government? So, that is clearly defined in the Indian constitution. Next, you can see the picture of a constituent assembly. Now, let us study what is constituent assembly and what it actually tells. The task of framing the constitution is given to a set of eminent people who are popularly elected. This group of people is together called the constituent assembly. So, constituent assembly is nothing but it is a group of people who are given a particular task. What is the task here? That is framing the constitution. And for framing the Indian constitution, the set of eminent people were elected. They were selected. How? From the election. Okay. A constituent assembly is usually set up for its specific purpose, which carries out in a relatively short time. After which the assembly is dissolved, a constituent assembly is a form of representative democracy. So, usually this assembly is made for a particular task. After it finishes its task, then it will be dissolved. So, that is why it is called as a constituent assembly. And another form, another word is also used for this is representative democracy. You can see here how the constituent assembly is formed and working in the assembly. How the formation and composition of the constituent assembly was made. In the examination, explain the formation and composition of the constituent assembly is asked many times. So, as we know about the history of Indian constitution, we can see that the constituent assembly of India was elected to write the constitution of India. So, what is the task of the constituent assembly? So, they are assigned with the writing of constitution of India. And it served as its first parliament. So, the parliament members of Indian constitution, first parliament members are nothing but they are the members of constituent assembly. It was set up as a result of negotiations between the leaders of the Indian independence movement and members of British, that is cabinet mission, before independence. So, students, you just see that this formation was made before independence. So, this is by the discussion between the leaders of Indian independence movement. Those are, as you know, Jawaharlal Nehru, Mahatma Gandhiji, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. So, those were the leaders of the Indian independent movement and with the British cabinet mission. So, they discussed and they made this setup before independence only. Okay. The constituent assembly was elected indirectly by the members of provincial legislative assembly which existed under the British Raj. So, this tells that, so before independence there was a British Raj, that is British rule, and there were provinces. ಪ್ರೊವಿನ್ಸಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಪ್ರಾಂತಗಳು, ಪ್ರದೇಶಗಳು. ಸೊ ನಮ್ಮ ದೇಶದಲ್ಲಿ ಬಹಳಷ್ಟು ಪ್ರಾಂತಗಳು, ಪ್ರದೇಶಗಳು ಇದ್ದು, ಸೊ ಅದರಿಂದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಪ್ರೊವಿನ್ಸಸ್ ಇಂದ ಸಮ್ ಇಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಮೇಡ್. ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ದ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್. ದೋಸ್ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೋನ್ ಆಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಲೆಜಿಸ್ಲೇಟಿವ್ ಅಸೆಂಬ್ಲಿ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದೇ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಸಮ್ ರಿಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಟಿವ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದೇರ್ ಪ್ರಾವಿನ್ಸಸ್. ಸೊ ದೋಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಮೆಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಯಂಟ್ ಅಸೆಂಬ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ವಾಸ್ ಮೇಡ್. ದ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂಗ್ತ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಯಂಟ್ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಬಾಡಿ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಯಂಟ್ ಅಸೆಂಬ್ಲಿ, ವಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ 389. So initially what is the total members in the Constituent Assembly? That is 389. In this 296 representatives from British India, so who where the British rule was there, and 93 representatives were from the Indian native states. So totally the strength was 389. Next, after the partition of the country on 15th August 1947, the strength of the Constituent Assembly got reduced from 389 to 308. So as you know that on 15th August 1947 we got the independence, and also our country partitioned into two nations, that India and Pakistan. So after partition you can see that the strength of the Constituent Assembly got reduced from 389 to 308. The Constituent Assembly represented by all prominent political leaders from all major regions, all major sections and communities of India. You can see that, so they were the representative, they were the eminent people elected from different major regions, different major sections and different communities of India. Okay, so all from all over the nation these members were selected and sent for the Constituent Assembly. The Constituent Assembly had its first sitting on 9th December 1946. So this first sitting we call it as a session. So this session was made first time in the year 1946 on 9th December, and Dr. Sachidanand, the oldest member of the house, was elected as the interim president. Interim means temporary. So he was the temporary president for this Constituent Assembly. Then Dr. Rajendra Prasad was elected as its permanent president on 11th December 1946. So you can see that, so this was all done before independence. Okay, then on August 15th 1947 India became an independent nation, and the Constituent Assembly started functioning as a India's parliament. So once when we got the independence, then this Constituent Assembly was started acting as a parliament, Indian parliament. Once the constitution took effect, the Constituent Assembly became the provisional parliament of India. It was provisional until the first elections under the government constitution took place in 1952. So after the first election, so this became the permanent parliament of India. Okay, I think it is clear for you. Okay students, let us study what is drafting committee and its contributions. On 29th August 1947, the Constituent Assembly appointed a drafting committee under the chairmanship of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, widely considered to be an architect of Constitution of India. As we all know that Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was the chairman of Indian Constitution, and he is also known as the architect of the Constitution of India. The drafting committee had 7 members including the chairman. They are Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, and other members were Alladi Krishnaswamy Iyer, K.M. Munshi, Mohammad Sadullah, N. Madha Rao, N. Gopalaswamy Iyengar and T.T. Krishnamachari. So these all were the members in a drafting committee. In February 1948, the first draft of the Indian Constitution was prepared After inspecting closely the draft of the constitution prepared by constitutional advisor B.N. Rao. Okay. Then it was published in English in all leading newspapers of the country to obtain public opinion. After the draft was prepared, so this draft constitution was published in all leading newspaper all over the country to get the opinion, ideas, suggestions from the public. It was placed before the Constituent Assembly and discussed the draft over 2 years, 11 months and 18 days. And finally, it was passed and signed by Dr. Rajendra Prasad, the President of the Constituent Assembly, on 26th November 1949. You can see this. So, at the end, finally, it was signed on 26th November 1949. But the Constitution of India came into force only from 26th January 1950. And is celebrated as the Republic Day of India. So, as we all know that 26th January is celebrated as Republic Day of India. So, this indicates on that day we have got our Indian Constitution came into force. And you can also remember, it is very important here, the time taken, the total time taken for preparation of Indian Constitution is 2 years, 11 months and 18 days. Okay. Once the constitution took effect, the Constituent Assembly became the Provisional Parliament of India. So, initially it was a provisional parliament. It was provisional until the first elections under the new constitution took place. So, after 1950, we had a first election on 1952. So, after that election, the Constituent Assembly, the members in the Constituent Assembly became the permanent members of the Parliament. Okay. So, I think it is clear for you. Okay. Dear students, let us revise quickly the framing of the Constitution through this picture here. As we have studied, before independence, there were various committees were formed to go into different aspects of the constitution. They submitted the report to assembly. Then B.N. Rao, a member of advisory branch of assembly, prepared a draft constitution under the chairmanship of B.R. Ambedkar and other members on 29 August 1947. They submitted this draft constitution prepared by the committee was submitted to the assembly on 21st February 1948. Then a special committee was appointed which went through all suggestions, comments and criticism with respect to the draft constitution. After this, members of drafting committee finalized the draft. Final draft was discussed clause by clause in the assembly and finally passed on 26th November 1949. Then the constitution was finally signed by members of assembly on 25th January 1950. So this was the last session, okay, the last day of assembly, and came into effect. The constitution came into effect from 26th January 1950. That day we celebrate as a Republic Day of India. I think the framing of constitution is very clear for you from this picture. You can quickly revise this. Dear students, let us conclude here. We have studied a very important topic, that is Introduction to Constitution of India. And we have studied how it was formed, how it was framed, and also what were the members in the Indian Constitution, what was Constituent Assembly. So, very important terms related to Indian Constitution we have studied. Go through it. So, if you have got any doubts, you can ask me at any time. So, okay. Thank you. Bye. Take care.